This week, Harry Potter, Scarface, and the Twilight Zone all become relevant to our interests. There's some beautiful art of what might have been, and my wallet is once again threatened by Lego products. Is J.J. Abrams spreading himself too thin? He's already got a lot going on, after all, between television shows like Person of Interest, Believe, and Almost Human, and the major Star Trek franchise. It's already impressive that he has the time for Star Wars at all. And now, he's gained the rights for yet another major geek venture, an unfilmed Rod Serling script. Now, I'll admit I am totally excited about this. I'm a huge Twilight Zone fanatic. I've watched the Sci-Fi Channel's New Year's Marathon every year since I was itty-bitty. And I think Abrams is well-suited for Serling's style of writing. Besides, the title, The Stops Along the Way, has such a cool, eerie sound about it that I am vibrating with excitement about it. But is this going to be that one thing too many? Let's just hope it doesn't divide his attention from Episode 7 too much. Speaking of Episode 7, it seems like every week we have a new rumored cast member. And a handful of people wanting to be cast members. What's frustrating is that it is so easy for people to forget that none of these names are actually confirmed. At this point, it is all speculation and wild rumors. While it's really fun to play, wouldn't it be cool? You should always be wary of presenting these castings as fact. Even the original cast members are still firmly unconfirmed. That said, the major rumor this week is that Florence of Florence and the Machine is being courted for a major role in Episode 7. Supposedly it was her singing that caught the attention of the bigwigs, which is odd considering the only musical characters that pop to mind from Episodes 1 through 6 are the Cantina players. I guess we can worry about that, however, when and if it ceases to be speculation. Now, as a girl with a not-so-secret Harry Potter obsession extending to a collection of foreign language editions and a shrine in my closet, it's no surprise that I got really excited about Daniel Radcliffe telling MTV that he would love a role in Episode 7. Besides my Potter mania, I think Radcliffe's a good actor and has a bright personality, and he has experience with manic, geeky fan bases. I think Abrams should seriously consider this one. What do you think? Let us know in the comments below. Switching from potential casting for future films to past films, Al Pacino talked a bit about how he had been asked to play Han Solo but turned it down because he thought the script was kind of weird. And fair enough. Did anyone else have fun imagining Scarface as a scruffy-looking nerf herder? Continuing with the theme of what might have been, there's this gorgeous book you can buy on Amazon. Just follow the link below. Called Star Wars Storyboards, the Prequel Trilogy. The Phantom Menace ones date back to 1997, so it's really cool to be able to track the changes that occurred between storyboarding and the finished product. I was particularly intrigued by some of the scenes showing young Anakin, since he seemed a little bit less innocent than in the film and a little bit more mischievous. The book is definitely a must-have for Star Wars fans and book hoarders, of which I am both. For those of you who would rather spend your money on toys than books, or want to spend your money on both, there's a new Lego Star Wars playset out there, and it is huge. Like, literally huge. The Ewok Village playset is super cool. But you don't have to take my word for it. You can follow the link for a video of the designer telling you all about it. I will tell you that the playset is a really excellent, featuring tons of details, cool tree forts, a way to stick your Han Solo minifig on a spit over the fire. It also features some exclusive minifigs, including Endor, Luke, and Leia, which, if you'll remember Leia's Ewok braided hair, yeah. There are a grand total of 16 minifigs, tons of tiny accessories, little bows and arrows, and fun features like trapdoors and swiveling bases. Besides, I loved the Ewoks as a kid. I think I rented those made-for-TV movies with the kids who crash-landed on Endor about a billion times. Okay, I'm going to leave you with some seriously sweet artwork depicting the original trilogy as Pulp Fiction paperback covers. If they actually existed, they would totally be my picks for poolside reading this summer. Just saying. Okay, well that's it for this week. For more salacious crumbs and other excellent news segments, subscribe to our channel. If you want to see the kind of things we're obsessed with, you can get social with us on Facebook, Twitter, and Pinterest. And for all your news, reviews, TV recaps, and interview needs, check us out at scififorme.com. Now, I'm going to go drool over that playset some more.